Hello and welcome to the Never Cast Off podcast. I'm Debbie.
I'm Sheila.
And we're here today to talk to you about whatever we feel like. Okay. You can find me on Ravelry, YouTube, and Instagram as Deb's Destiny.
And I am on Instagram as Blue Yarn Always and Ravelry, and this is episode 27. And it's December 10th? December 10th. However, this probably won't upload till December 11th.
And I lied. I'm not on YouTube.
She is on YouTube, but she's under the channel of the Never Cast Off podcast.
There you go. What the heck am I thinking?
So I hope you're all doing well. You had a smooth December, I guess. We have no snow here in Michigan, which is great.
That's terrible.
Yeah, I like it.
I love snow.
And moving on to the morning announcements.
We don't have any.
We have no hellos in the group.
So we're still just going to say hi to you, though.
Hi!
And so even if you don't say hi to us, we're still saying hi to you. We're going to hunt you down. No, we're not. But we're still going to say hi.
We hope you had a good Thanksgiving, if you celebrated.
And I hope you ate lots of turkey, but not too much.
Yep, now it's getting ready to make turkey soup.
Yeah, I froze it. I still have a lot.
I froze. I had 33 pounds of turkey.
Wow.
17 people. So I froze to make soup in January.
Yeah, that's what I'm going to be doing.
Make soup in January.
Folks were just giving me turkeys, and I ended up having so many, and then I had one already in the refrigerator, and then I had a second one that I got, a fourth one, but this one, it started thawing by the time I got it home, so I couldn't put it in the freezer, so on Thanksgiving, I cooked a whole turkey, and then 2 days later, the next day, I cooked in a whole another one.
Oh my goodness.
So it was probably about 35 pounds of turkey that most of it went into the freezer.
Wow, that's a lot.
It is. And then I was taking some out, and I don't know what happened to the plastic bag, but my cat sure enjoyed that it went all over the floor. Kitty's like, ooh, this tastes yummy.
Oh, yeah, they like that.
Yeah, she didn't last year. Last year, she looked at me like, I'm a cat. How can you give me this? And she just turned her nose up. But this year she thinks, hey, it tastes good.
Yep, not bad.
Yeah. So what's next on the list?
Let's see. End of the knitting podcast.
So
escapees. Escapees. Do you have any escapees?
None for me.
None for you. I have some. I have easy stuff. Because I was going to start knitting like hats and cowls and things like that for myself. But in January, I'm going to start using my hand spun. So I don't really want to use commercial yarn. So I've just been making little things. And this is the first little thing. This is called an acorn jar cover. And I don't have the pattern, but it's on my project page. But it is called the acorn jar cover, and it's a free pattern. And basically, this is a pint-sized canning jar. Slips in.
Oh, that is so adorable.
Yep. And I think I'm going to use this next fall to put out and put, like, little candies in there. I'm glad you thought it was an acorn as soon as you seen it. But this is crocheted. And this was crocheted using, here you go. Oh, glare. Acorn Jar Cozy by Brianna Olson. And it's a free pattern.
Thank you, Brianna.
And I just used some Red Heart Super Saver, and Aaron Fleck. And then I believe this brown is Mary Maxim's yarn for the top. So it's nice just to use the acrylic yarn. And then you just get a little something. So I did that little something something. And then I decided to use up some scraps. These are all ends. Barocco Comfort, which I believe is a nylon and acrylic. But they got nice colors, right?
Yeah, it's worth it. Nice colors. It's kind of nice.
So I also found a pattern by Jesse Spencer. And it was
Hi, Jesse. Sorry.
It was a business card holder. So you would put your business cards in. If you know somebody that has business cards. And they want to put them on their desk.
Okay, the lighting is still a little bit different.
Yeah. It's like a cranberry color and a yellow. But it's just a little crocheted. And else, this is also a little free pattern. Takes like, what, an hour to make this, put this together. But then I was also thinking about making some of these here. The ends are not in, but I'm counting it done. For when I sew, to put bobbins in here.
That would be
cute. That way, after I fill a bunch of bobbins, they're all right in here. It's a cute little thing, and it goes so quick.
If you were to line it with a simple napkin or something like that, you could even put candies or something like that in there too.
Probably. But this is the business card holder by Jesse Spencer. And what other little project did I do? Oh, I finished the sock. That's it. I finished one sock. Well, one sock. The sock with the ditch in it.
Oh.
And this is...
So you just stop whenever you want to, or you just keep going until it runs out?
No, because I do toe up. I try it on as I go. And then I stop. I'm not a big... I don't like my socks that high up. But I try the sock on as I go. And this is out of the Regia... Color is called Show. And this is one done. And right here is where I see the ditch.
That's cool.
It's like a pearl ditch that goes all the way up until I get to my ankle, I guess.
Until you turned it.
Yeah. And then the sweet tomato heel and Jenny's stretchy bind off. But it's my standard usual recipe, 64. But I was using some different needles. These here. I think these are, oh my gosh, I don't have the wrapper. But I'm sure you guys know what needles these are. They're like so pointy. Feel how pointy they are. And they have the red cable on them. Oh. They called Addie's Lace.
Chai Goo's. Twos.
Chai Goo twos, yep. This is my first time using these. Boy, you can really knit a quick one on these things.
Okay.
Because, yeah. The sharpness.
I have some of their needles, and I like them where I mostly use the Knitter's Pride ones.
Oh, yeah.
I really like the wood. I really love the wood. My hands are always cold, so I always go for the wood because it's a warmer material to knit with.
The wood?
Yeah. So I tend to just go for that. But I always say that name, that designer name of the Chiawa.
Chai Goo?
Yeah. Chai Goo. But I really like their needles.
I like the needles too. And then, so it's been, I guess I'm on a crochet roll. So my coworkers, two of my coworkers, I made them Charisma. And this is just acrylic yarn. So each one took two skeins. This one is made out of charcoal and off-white. And all it is just double crochets, half double crochets. Got to weave in all these ends here. I'm considering it done. But, so technically, if you were to put this on, see, got a lot on. But yeah, it's nice and soft.
Very pretty.
It'll be easy for them to wash. And then the other one is made out of taupe and off-white.
This isn't
same
your,
thing.
This isn't your grandma's acrylic.
No. This is very soft. So this is, another one. Same thing. We'll put it on. It's just the acrylic. I don't know how many I cast on. I don't know how many I crocheted on. I went in the front. I went in the back to get this little ribbon pattern.
Mm-hmm.
Half doubles, singles. So they can wear it however they like. One has a tan coat. One has the charcoal coat. And it's very soft, though. It's very, very soft.
I think they're going to be very happy with them.
Yeah. So this is for them because next year I don't know if we'll be working together. So, and I've known one of them for, well, I've known both of them for 14 years.
Mm.
So, but it's not even cold enough here in Michigan to wear a cowl because it's like 57 degrees.
Oh my gosh. It's been in the 50s this week in mm-hmm. December. That is so, and that's Fahrenheit. It's so unusual to have that in December for us. The past 2 years, it's been below zero in January, and December is usually closer to 30 for the high,
yep,
or maybe 40, somewhere in there. So to have, you know, 50s, you know, what the heck is that? I mean, no, it's...
They call it El Nino or El Nin.
Yeah.
El Nina, something like that.
The little sister.
It's just very odd. But that is all I have for yarn-related escapees.
Okay. Well, I had a whole bunch of, I'm doing a PowerPoint presentation, and they wanted to do something about your hobbies. So I picked yarn. Can you imagine that?
And if you follow, can I just say, if you follow Deb on Instagram, you've seen, is that all your stash or some?
Most.
Okay, and if you don't follow her on Instagram, you probably should, because, oh my God.
And I stacked up, I took all of my bins, and instead of just dumping all the yarn out, because they're already organized, so each, right, you know, one bin has, like,
cotton,
one has wool, one has alpaca, and they have about, and then there's some that are lace and sock, mm-hmm, or whatever. So I just took the bins and put them on the couch and lined them up and put the, you know, so I don't know, 10, 12, I don't even know how many bins I have. I need to count them for the presentation. And so I put them up there and I just stacked them, and they stack so nicely on my couch. You can't even see the couch, literally.
No, I didn't even know they were in a couch.
Yeah. So,
follow her on Instagram.
And then what happens is you can't even see that it's the whole bins are full. So you can't even see that, but that's okay. But I was just trying to say, I got some yarn. No, I don't have a problem. Oh yeah. Somebody said, I think you might have a problem. I don't know what you're talking about. I don't have a problem. I don't have a problem. I think No, I'm kidding.
I think I made a comment like, can I come over and knit?
Or no, you said let's knit.
Yeah, let's knit.
The cat lady ended up saying, I want to come over and play. I said, come on over.
Yeah, Andrea.
She's actually not that far from us. I'm not exactly sure where she is, but I know she's like the next county over or something like that. So she could probably get to my house in less than an hour.
We could knit.
So we could probably even do a joint podcast. That would be fun. Maybe. I don't know. We'd have to talk about it. It might be better to just talk about it privately than she's like, she gets out and says, stick to the list. I'm sorry. Yeah, I don't even know if anybody's interested in that. I'm just la 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 la. Okay. So when I had my whole stash out there, I'm like, oh, I could cast that one on. Ooh, I could start something with that one. Ooh, I want to. Oh, wait. And so I pulled like 6 different bags because everything of mine's in plastic bags. I pulled 6 bags out to start projects.
Did you?
I only started one. So the one that Sheila had for her coworkers like that.
Oh, the cowl?
Yeah. This is going to be similar to that, but it's all going to be pink.
But you're knitting it, too.
I'm knitting it.
Yeah.
And I doubled some.
What yarn are you using? It looks like cotton. Is it cotton?
It's Cascade yarn.
Merino silk.
Yeah, Merino silk.
Nothing like loving your neck with some silk. Yeah.
This is Venzia.
Venzia Merino Silk.
Yeah.
It's wool, 70% wool and 30% silk. And what's the color? Oh, look, it's a number. Color 112.
Didn't feel it.
I know. It looks soft.
Yeah, so I want to do like a cowl.
Reminds me of the Easter bunny. The pink.
Yeah, so I'm going to do it for Christmas for me. Happy Christmas, Debbie. It's for me. No. and yeah, I like pink. I do.
You can't tell.
I know.
You have anything else hanging on the wire?
Oh, I thought that was just like a new cast on. But yeah. I brought this just to show because I think I got a little bit further than the last, but I don't remember where I was.
Do you have a progress keeper?
Or
that's too heavy for that?
I think I have it, but it was heavy and it was getting caught, so I took it off. But yes, I do have progress keepers. So could you hold this like right here?
Mm-hmm.
So it comes across like that. So then it goes back and forth. Up. So that's how this one works. So this one is from a way cool designer. And this pattern is live. And Dutch Mama is the lady. The very, very nice lady.
Dutch Mama's her Ravelry ID?
Yes. And I can't remember the name of it. Okay, tell me about one of yours.
Is it on a project page?
Yes.
Well, then they can just reference your project page. If you've got a project page made, right?
Yeah. Nope, that's not it. Nope, that's not it. Nope. Okay. If I can't find it, Leola.
Leola?
Yeah. Leola.
Leola.
Yeah.
So, okay.
She's very nice. If you ever get stuck, you can talk to her. And I like to pick on Sheila. She makes these like wonderful things for me, and then I pull out a plastic bag.
Oh my god!
I do that just to pick on her.
You're hooked on Ziploc and Hefty.
I should buy stock.
You're hooked on Ziploc and Hefty.
Okay, so this
wow, look at you.
This is my first sock.
That is nice.
And I'm too like right. Here on the second sock.
Did you try it on?
No. And no? I'm not going to do it during the middle of the podcast.
Oh, okay.
No, that's not going to happen today. I'm sorry. And I'm just doing a simple rib just because I thought it would pull it in a little bit more. And it might stay up better, I guess.
Cute.
So I haven't decided how far up I want to go. I usually keep it a little bit lower.
I like to the ankle.
Yeah, but if it's one that you fold over, you need just a little bit more. But I just, and that's why I just had to cast on with 13s. Because I have two projects that are like twos and zeros. 13, darn it.
Okay.
Yeah, I prefer nines and eights.
I but hear you.
Whatever. It's good to know.
Let's see. What do I got? Currently.
That is really pretty, by the way.
I'm making. Let me just finish these couples. I am making a hitchhiker. For someone I don't know.
She's very generous.
Yeah. I don't know this person. The yarn is Woolmize. And the color is Guide to the Galaxy. It's 100% superwash merino. Ooh, that color comes up good, too. It's all caked up.
Yeah, we're playing with the brightness, so, and this is where I am so far. That's on the pretty. The teeth. She's got a little bit of pooling. So I'll start up here. Little stripe. There's cool. A little pool right there. Maybe it's the galaxy. Pretty. Yeah, very, very easy knit. So, and what else do I have? I'm still test knitting for Deb, but I left that upstairs. What's it called?
It's the cover up. Ethereal.
Ethereal cover. Out of the Sunseekers cotton. I'll probably have it more towards the end of the month.
That's fine. That pattern is live, by the way.
If you're looking for a nice cover up.
Yeah, if you're going on a warm vacation in the winter.
Mm-hmm.
Or wherever you are. It is summer.
Yep, somewhere it is.
Australia.
Let me break that yarn. And then I also started, I don't know why I did this either, but starting doing a chevron baby blanket. So it's a
J. Is there something you want to tell us?
Yeah. So, J, of course I've been doing a lot of crocheting. Can't you tell? Everything's basically crocheted. So I found this yarn. Let me back it up a little bit. And it was one skein, and it's acrylic yarn. Come on.
It's a pastel. It goes from blue to green to yellow. Yeah. Blue, green, yellow.
Yep, it doesn't work. But it's very light pastel. Pastels. So I had one skein. Here's the skein right here.
Pink.
And this is as far as I got, which, of course, is not big enough to cover up a baby.
Unless you cut it in half and then go like that.
Yeah.
But why would you do that? It's done.
So I used up the whole big skein, and it was a huge skein, like a pounder skein. And now I don't know if I have any more, and I don't know how old this yarn is. So I'm thinking I might have to crochet, because it's for a boy, I'm thinking I might have to crochet, add onto here, and add onto here, and this would be the middle. So this would be the middle of the blanket, and then add on here, and add on this side.
Did you still have some more left?
No, there's none. I use it all.
Okay.
There's none of this. I can look in my totes, but I highly doubt it because I separated all the baby yarn.
You could do white, too, if you don't know what it is.
It's a boy.
Oh.
It's a boy. So, yeah, that's my crocheting. Crochet. Even though I don't know. I start a baby blanket knowing I only have one skein of yarn.
So you aren't making an announcement, huh?
So I should not be surprised that I run out of yarn.
She was not making an announcement. She's not expecting.
No, no announcement, but I only have one skein of yarn. Do I really think I'm going to make a baby blanket? No. But apparently I did because I spent all that time. Oh, well, so it is. It is what it is. I'm not ripping it out. I'm going to add to it, and I'll be creative, and I'll figure something out.
Sounds like a plan.
Yeah, it's good enough.
So what do you have next for us?
Next is DIY. Do you have any DIY? DIY, spinning, sewing,
I didn't bring it. I did create something.
What'd you create?
I love going with my mom hunting for a Christmas tree. Oh, my gosh. It was so much fun. This tree was like 40 pounds.
Oh, my gosh.
It's a Douglas fir, and we didn't think it was a Douglas fir. We wanted a white pine, which is cheaper. But the guy was standing right there, blah, 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 whatever. And so the tree trunk was like this big at the bottom. So, I mean, it was so big and so heavy. So we cut up, and I had lots of branches.
Would you make a vine or a wreath?
I got out a pot with dirt, and I made a arrangement out of it, but I forgot to take a picture.
No, those are so cool.
I'll have to take a picture of it.
Yeah, put it on your Instagram.
I think I will.
And then I'll like it.
Okay. Even if you do. Even if you don't, there's going to be a heart with your name next to it.
That's right. I'm going to like it.
The one that was on the front banister of my place,
the front entryway. I didn't look at it during in daylight, so I don't even know what that one looks like. But the pot turned out nice because I did that one inside the house and then I could see what it was. But the other one, as I tied it up to the railing thingy, it could have fallen apart a little bit and I may not have known it was falling apart.
Well, that's not good.
So I'll have to put it on Instagram.
Yep. Everybody will get a peek at it. For DIY, I have some sewing. Oh, let's see. For my sister. Well, I wish the color. This is flannel. She purchased this material for me, and I didn't really care for it, so I decided to make her a French seam pillowcase with a white cotton sash. So I'm hoping she'll like it. This just not me. You're looking at it like, ugh.
No, it's pretty.
But she's getting a nice flannel pillowcase. And then for the girls, isn't this fun?
Oh, it is.
Whee! An American Girl doll sleeping bag. Ain't this the cutest?
Oh, look. So that's for like the little girl. Look. Or the
American Girl doll. And then over here you have the buttons with rubber band holders so you can open this up to put your dolly in and then tuck them in the flannel.
Aww.
So when they're done and there's no sleepover, they roll it up and it stores like this. So this is one.
That is so cool.
This is the second one. Let's see. That's kind of dramatic, right? This is the second one, which is paisley. Yep, paisley. Here you go. Pink paisley. Got pretty buttons here. And of course, the dolly is going to have a... And this is from a tutorial on YouTube. There's a lot of tutorials on YouTube. But I chose this one because the tutorial was like 7 minutes. Very easy. And then my one niece, who's 4, she doesn't have an American Girl doll, but she has tons and tons of Barbies. Because her sister gave her kind of all the broken Barbies. So we don't want her to be left out. So I made her a Winnie the Pooh sleeping bag. And look how big this is. She can get all of her Barbies in here. She
just line them right up.
unbuttons these little hard buttons here.
Doesn't matter if they're missing a head or a leg or an arm.
That's right. She can get like tons of dolls in there.
So you feel bad for her. So you made hers the biggest.
She's got the biggest because she doesn't have an American Girl doll. Okay. But we already figured that she'll try to shove maybe at least 8 or 9, 10 Barbies in here.
Okay.
You know, and stuffed animals and whatever else she has. But she got the biggest one and she got the Winnie the Pooh one. But the other girls are older.
Winnie the Pooh. Winnie
so, the Pooh. That is my DIY. Oh, wait a minute. I got a few other things. So I also been sewing for the Etsy shop. For Thank God for Bags. On Etsy. Thank God for Bags. I've been doing some sewing. So we have that. These are all going to be put in the Etsy shop. So that one there.
Hold it at an angle like this.
So yeah. This one here. Yeah. And these have interfacing on them, so they'll sit up sturdy. Let me move this one all the way. This one's for your hot projects. Or if you got something hot you want to carry. That also has interfacing in it. And then these two do not have any interfacing in them. So okay. This is just blue with a little pink blue flower in it. And then
this box! It's like we're from Michigan.
That's right. Detroit Tigers. And this one does not have interfacing in it either. So these two are pretty collapsible to where these ones are sturdy.
And we're going to run out of room.
Got orange in here. Which one? I think these ones just have the plain because there's a lot going on. This is just the plain yellow. But these are going to go up in the Etsy shop. And then there's also two coupon codes there too. So there's free shipping. If you want free shipping, just type in free shipping. And that's good till January 5th of 2016. And if you don't mind paying for shipping, you can get 10% off by entering in TGFB, thank God for bags, 2015, and that's good till the end of the year.
Okay, so it's one or the other, and the free shipping is only for United States.
Correct. I'm only doing domestic currently at this time, so thanks for bringing that up. So if you order one or more bags, my suggestion is go with the free shipping. If you want a percentage off, then get a percentage off. But if you're going to order more than one bag, me personally, I would free shipping if you're ordering more than one bag.
Okay.
It's up to you. But yeah, that's my sewing adventures. That is all my DIY.
Adventures in sewing.
Adventures in sewing.
Okay. So
I do have some satellite store. Because I, on Small Business Saturday, I did go on Etsy, and I did support some Etsy sellers. Ooh. Or Etsy shops. Yeah. And I only have one of them with me. I'll have to bring the other one next time. But this is from At a Glance Bags, and I've seen this. Even though I make bags, I still like bags. You know what I mean? Who doesn't like bags? I like all kinds of bags. So here's her card.
Oh, tilt it.
Wait. Oh. There you go. At a glance. Yep. Okay. Now, ain't this the coolest thing?
It's see-through.
Look, we're, do you have any yarn?
No.
Let's see.
You know what? Yours right here, it will...
Well, here, I'll put this in here.
It won't stick out very well because it's light colored.
Let me get this here.
I just use this one.
There you go. Oh, no, no, I don't want to do that one because that's not my yarn. And if it frays or... I'm making that for someone.
Good. It's all good.
But there you go.
You can see through that. That's so
you can
cool.
See what, and look at the bottom. There's sheep. Oh, it's a flat bottom. Ain't that cool? And it's called At a Glance Bags. The other thing I bought from Etsy is part of a Christmas present for my daughter.
Besides the other one you already gave her.
Yeah. And because she has a Fitbit, but I found an Etsy seller on Fitbit who does monogramming. I'll have to show next podcast, but I bought it for her Fitbit because she does wear one of them Fitbits. And the Fitbits are all black and or they're just different colors. So really, if you laid it down somewhere and maybe somebody else laid down one too, how are you going to know which one's yours? So this is kind of like something that would, she would know that it's hers, I guess. But I'll show it next podcast. I haven't received it yet because they have to print. I have to print it.
Okay.
So, but that was my Small Business Saturday support. And I want to thank the people who purchased from my Etsy shop too. I really appreciate it, and I hope you like it. The ladies left reviews on the Etsy shop, so that was really nice.
Yeah, I appreciate all the people that are buying my patterns too. I appreciate that very much.
That's cool.
Yeah.
See? Win-win.
Absolutely.
So I think we're going to have one more podcast before Christmas, right?
Yeah.
We plan on it, but things happen, so we plan on one more. And then for the month of January, we're going to go over new goals and did we meet our 2015 goals.
Oh, no. I better get started. Catching up.
And then I also want to do something. I haven't told Deb this, but
uh-oh.
I'm just saying for me.
All yours. Because,
but I was thinking, since, you know, I've been doing a lot of holiday knitting and knitting for this one and that one and knitting for everybody else, I haven't really knitted too much for myself. Right? Have you? Well,
I am a very selfish knitter. I very rarely knit for anybody else. I'll knit for my mom or me.
Okay. Well, I was thinking along the lines of in the month of January. So if you want to participate, I'll probably open a thread on January 1st. And basically what this is going to consist of is in your queue, on the first page of your queue of all the patterns that you really, really like or you really want to make, during the month of January, I will be randomly gifting people one pattern from their first page of their Ravelry queue. But there's more to come on that. So I'll have to know that you want to participate. And if you're not a member of the group, jump over to the group, because you're going to have to be a member to participate
in Ravelry. And you'll have to be on Ravelry.
Yeah, you'll have to be a member of our group to participate. But I think in the month of January, because I want to start knitting things for me, like the Babble hat, and I have two more cowls that I want to finish. And I think there's a shawl that I want to cast on. So I was figuring, oh, and it's our Podaversary in January, too.
Our Podaversary.
Yeah, it's a Podaversary. 1 year. So, yeah, Podaversary. It's going to be Selfish Knitting Month. It's going to be the first month of knitting all my hand spun.
Yeah,
there's a lot going on. There's a lot going on in January. So, yeah, get over to the group if you're a member. Get your queue, the first page of items that you want. I'll be gifting patterns randomly.
I think in February, if you're doing that January, then in February, and we're doing this on the fly, so we might talk after and then scramble it up a little bit. But in the first quarter, I'm also going to want, I heard about this and I've wanted to do it since the summer, but just haven't made it happen. To have everybody start working on a project, and you don't know what it's going to be until the first person says, "Is that a hat?" And then you have to make it a hat. So you start a project not knowing what it's going to be. And as soon as somebody says, "Oh my gosh, that looks like it's a shawl." and then just make it into a shawl. So whatever somebody suggests, then you have to do it. But I have to figure out how to say it a little bit easier. That's just a little weird.
That sounds interesting.
Yeah, but I mean, it's a fun, crazy type of thing, so that, you know, you start something. Oh my goodness, that, you know, like when we were doing the market bags, everybody thought that they were hats. So if you start making just something and then somebody says, "Oh my goodness, is that a," and just hope they don't say sweater.
Oh my gosh. Yeah, you don't want that.
Oh no, it's a coat.
Yeah, but I
next... that looks like a coat.
When did we start? I think we started a podcast in the beginning of January.
Yes, it was the first week. It was like the first few days of January.
Yeah, so mm-hmm. It's our Podaversary month.
Yes, it is.
Okay, so yeah, so we'll have review our goals, go over our new goals. We'll have a little contest thread. We'll have hand spun. And Debbie's, what are you knitting? Idea that she's going to capture.
Yeah, we'll try and get a snazzier name that is a little bit more direct to the point of what the heck are you talking about, you know, and so to try and get it a little bit cleaner of a topic.
Yeah. So stay tuned. And if you're not a member of the group, get in on the group. If you want to follow us on Instagram, feel free. Blue Yarn Always.
Deb's Destiny.
Yep. We'll follow you back. We post in between podcasts random things on Instagram.
Oh, yeah. I put one of my cat chasing something under the door this morning. It was fun.
Yeah.
You're like, yeah, maybe not.
No, I seen it. She was trying to get the red feather underneath the door. Yeah, I seen that. That was cute.
And there's no kitty faces, just paws. Okay, it really doesn't take much to amuse me. It really doesn't.
That was cute. But I think
that's... cute, but just not that cute.
Okay. No, it was cute. I don't have anything else.
Okay, me too.
Okay.
Me neither.
So I guess we'll either see you before Christmas or after Christmas. Thanks for watching. Thanks for all the new viewers.
You rock.
All the returning viewers.
You rock more.
God, thank you for coming back.
Oh my goodness, thank you. We couldn't do this without you. Or actually we could, but it might be weird. So thank you. You guys have a wonderful, wonderful week.
Bye-bye.